You know, I'm going to go out on a limb here and say that anger is the root of all evil. I really do believe that a lot of the evil that we see in the world today, which you see all the time on the news, is really the result of angry people. I think it's important to remember that evil people weren't always evil. In fact, I believe that it was a situation in their life that caused them to grow angry, caused them to grow bitter, in which they became evil. Here's the thing about anger, is that anger loves a pity party. Anger loves to bring other people down. And so when evil people act out and do these horrible, outrageous things, really what they're doing is they're passing along the pain to other people of the anger that's really inside of their hearts.
Anger is a secondary emotion. It's not the primary emotion. Anger comes from fear, frustration, and hurt. So if you're involved in things where you feel hurt, it's going to result and reflect itself in anger. And what anger really is, in fact, the actual definition of the word forgiveness, which is just the opposite of anger, is knotting up inside. When we start getting angry and we stay angry for a long period of time, what we're actually doing is knotting up inside.
I think it's crazy to think that at one point in my grandfather's life, he was angry that my grandpa learned the incredible value of forgiveness.
Forgiveness is not forgetting about what somebody did to us. So I don't want people to resist the idea of forgiveness because they think, well, that means I have to forget. No, you won't forget, but we'll do something with that memory and you'll see it. It doesn't mean you're going to trust this person anymore. Forgiveness doesn't mean you're going to be reconciled. You're going to be this person's friend again. It doesn't necessarily mean that. You may not be. Does that mean that we can't learn how to forgive? No, it doesn't. I don't care what their response is. We have a responsibility to learn how to forgive. We have got to look at anger for what it really is and the damage it's doing and say, let's help each other get this anger out of our life.
Well, my grandfather found himself in the clutches of anger. I actually found myself in the clutches of anger as well. I was an angry person. If you would have asked me back when I was going through all this, if I was an angry person, I would have told you no. In fact, I'm happy. Things are going good for me. But in reality, I was extremely angry. It's because I was teased a lot growing up. In fact, the very first time I remember being teased was in the sixth grade. And it was over and over and over again, and I never really feel like I could enter into strong relationships with people because I was afraid of the teasing, I was afraid of the bullying, and I really wanted nothing to do with that stuff. And I remember the pain from my anger would really kind of start to drift into other areas of my life. I found myself not excited about our family traditions like decorating the Christmas tree or hunting for Easter eggs, and I started treating my little sisters differently without respecting them, and I certainly wasn't respecting my mom and dad, and I was kind of a pill to live with in high school. But I remember everything changed when I made the decision to forgive. And how I came to that decision was I played a lot of golf, and my dad and I used to love to go out on the golf course together, and we would just talk about life, and we would talk about things I was struggling with.
I knew that we needed to talk about it. Because anger just doesn't have a way of just going away. Is we really do need the tools to be able to get rid of our anger. And a lot of times, sometimes we want to hold on to that anger, really thinking, you know what, if I hold on to this, I can hurt that person. Or we think about revenge. We think about things that we can do back to them, thinking that we're really hurting them, but instead all we're doing is really hurting ourselves even more. So Michael and I really did spend a lot of time on the golf course. He's a really good golfer. And so it was a lot of fun being out there with him. It's not fun being outdriven and him beating me all the time. My heart was breaking for him. And to be able to go into those dark places, it is painful. And as a parent, you want to rear up. You want to eat into those people that are hurting you. But instead, I knew this was Michael. Michael had to learn to go through this because life is hard.
It was through those experiences that I really found the freedom to be able to forgive. I want to give you encouragement if you are sitting there thinking to yourself, you know, this kind of sounds familiar. This kind of sounds like I might have some anger. That's where you need to move to forgiveness because it's going to give you incredible freedom to be able to live your life with the highest quality possible. And it's also going to allow you to be able to enter into even greater relationships with people.
Hachette.